look, you're gonna be all right.
I'm all right. I'm worried about you.
I'm doing fine.
No, you shouldn't come here.
Luke, I'm not complaining. Can you understand that? I'm doing fine. You're the one who's sick.
I'm not sick. I'm just worried about your being here. That's all.
Luke,
it's too dangerous.
How many times do we have to go over and over that? Don't you understand?
Look, I should have never let you come here on the spot.
Well, you didn't have much to say about it after what happened to O'Reilly.
You know, O'Reilly was a very smart old lady, and she would have never let you come on this boat.
No, she would have been the first to understand why I would want to be here with you in danger instead of at home in Port Charles worrying about you. Are you listening? Are you too sick to hear what I'm saying?
What are you saying?
I'm saying that we promised each other we were going to be together. Always. Remember?
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
Well, this is probably something that we're going to remember as long as we live. I mean, I can just see us when we're just like Ma and Pa Whitaker, you know? We're sitting there in our rocking chairs side by side, just rocking away. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. I'm really sorry. You're okay. You okay?
Yeah.
Anyway, I'll say to you, Luke, remember the time that we were in that cargo hold together in that boat and you got seasick?
I'm not sick.
Yes, you are. And you'll say, Laura, that's not a boat. That was not a boat. That was a ship. An honest-to-goodness ship with people up on top who wanted to rule the world, but we wouldn't let them do it.
Oh, honey. You really make a guy not want to upchuck.
I love you. You're going to be okay.
You think that this whole thing is going to turn out all right, don't you?
Of course I do. I'm really sure of it. And in the meantime, we're not going to sit down here quaking in our boots, are we? No. No way. We're going to make it, aren't we? You, me, Robert, together, we're going to make it. You got to believe that, Luke. I do. I feel totally confident about this whole thing. Why are you looking at me like that?
Because you have changed so much since I first met you.
I know. It's your fault, too. You have yourself to blame for that, because you taught me. Luke, are you all right?
What is wrong with me?
I don't know. What is wrong with you? Maybe you just need something to eat, huh?
No, don't talk about food.
Oh. There's Robert. Ladies?
Hi. Oh, out for an early lunch.
Aha.
Well, you sure look nice today, Monica.
Sure, I wish I felt that way. I have a couple of errands to run, and then I'm going to be home at lunch.
Mm-hmm. Checking out early, then.
You say.
Right. Good heavens! What do we have here?
I got a bad sprain.
Oh.
Doc Rick's going to fix it.
Well, couldn't get a better man. You take care.
Well, hey, what happened to you?
I got a bad sprain. Aww. Doc Rick's gonna take pictures of it.
Yeah, Amy, could you run him down to X-ray for me, please?
I sure can.
Okay. And a wheelchair hand. There we go.
Hold that chair. You ever been in a wheelchair before?
Gee, no, can I?
You sure can.
Yeah, okay, release your arm. Now, watch that leg.
Can I go real fast?
Well, I think maybe Amy better push it in before I forget one tennis shoe and slip. Okay.
Gee,
I wish Corky was here.
Corky? Yes.
My best friend.
I know.
Georgia.
Corky? I've got to go down to CICU for a minute. I'm expecting Leslie. Would you tell her and send her on down for me?
Sure, right away. And, Rick, I'm terribly sorry about what happened. I know you must be worried sick.
Well, I am a little uptight about it, yes.
You know, everything happened so fast down at that clinic. And then when Laura and Luke brought that woman in, and I just wish I could have gotten some more information for you.
Sure, you're ridiculous. Thank you very much for being so cool. You did a nice job.
Thanks. But I just wish that I'd ask some more questions. Have you heard anything more about what happened?
Well, we got a letter from Laura today.
Oh, then you've heard from her. That's great.
Well, she's fine, and she's with Luke.
Ah, thank God for that.
Well, at least it's some form of communication.
Well, that's a good sign, isn't it?
I guess so, but what is really frustrating is not knowing exactly where she is.
This must be awful.
Yeah, what I would really like is to be able to help. I can't lift one finger. I'd just find out where they are. I'll be down there. Please let her know.
Right. Thank you.
Just about does it.
How am I doing now?
You're doing very well. I'm going to have you out of CICU.
All right. You're going to move me out of here?
Yeah, I guess send you up to the 7th floor. Get there with Toby.
Okay.
Be able to do a little work on that knee for you as well.
All right. Thank you. It's kind of painful.
Yeah, well, therapy will take care of it. Well, be careful with it.
Stephen Traffic, I'm sorry. Hello.
That's right.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Okay, thank you. Listen, I heard about what happened. I'm sorry.
Yeah, so thank you. Can we talk?
Sure, I'm just finishing up now. They ought to be up sometime today to take you up to 7.
All right, thank you. Oh, sure. Dr. Weber, before you go, have you heard anything about Laura yet?
No, we haven't.
What did those two get into?
We don't know. They just left town with a trail of unanswered questions behind them.
Absolutely waiting to be plundered. Listen, tell Luke to stay there. We'll pass the food to him.
Luke, stay there. Okay? I'll
talk to you. Okay. Stand by for this. Here. Here's some orange juice. You might need that. Corn. We can leave for a plate. Ice cream. There's someone coming.
Brunch? Brunch?
I was told you were serving brunch.
Well,
obviously I was misinformed. My fault entirely.
Right.
Oh, look at that. Strawberries, eh?
Yeah.
Strawberries in the middle of the sea. Take a long time when you cross now.
Well, yes.
Bertie, you're a very lucky man. Great chaps, these Cassadines. You must enjoy working for them very much.
Yeah.
What? Well, toodle pip.
Goodbye.
I almost fainted when I saw her handwriting. Dear Mom and Dad, wait, read this yourself. I don't have to.
Thanks. Dear Mom and Dad, I have gone away with Luke. I don't want to upset you anymore nor worry you as I did last summer, but it was necessary. Please do not worry about me. I'm a big girl now, and Luke will take care of me. There's so much I want to explain right now, but I only have a moment to write this. I will contact you as soon as I can with all my love. Laura. At least it's a letter. It's something.
I know, but it's not enough. I want to know more.
How about the cab driver? You talked to Bobby?
No, I tried. I talked to her, yes, because I wanted to tell her about the letter.
Well, had she heard from
her? No, she hadn't, but she hadn't found Slick either.
I just may know someone who knows what he might
do. Who?
Rose at the Gullies. He used to come in there all the time. Well, when Luke was around.
Hello, Kelly's Diner.
Rose, hi, it's Rick.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, fine. Look, I'd like to ask you something. Have you seen Slick Jones?
Sure, yeah, and I did tell him that Bobby Spencer was looking for him.
You told him?
Yeah, but he sure didn't seem in a big hurry to get in touch with her.
But do you know if he's coming by again or when he might be there?
You can see him yourself if you want to.
What do you mean?
He's sitting right here at the counter and he just started lunch.
I think... Now, almost this front, huh? Mustn't oversleep again.
Well, Eddie, if I were you, then I would make sure that you tell the steward to wake you up next
time. I certainly shall. I don't want to miss a bite of your menu ever.
Well, that's good. And I guess, as soon as we arrive there, you're going to be very busy. So ask the steward whatever you want. Anything.
Oh, I met an absolutely charming chap whilst I was going around looking for brunch.
Well, we have a splendid crew.
I'd say everything is splendid, and that goes double for you, my dear young lady.
Thank you, Mr.
Nigel.
Oh, thank you.
We should move that bishop.
And you should move out into the sunch.
Oh, come on, Corin, it's an endless game sometimes.
Does he have you trapped, General?
Very difficult trapping me.
Mm-hmm. But I think I have. Check.
Mate. Mm. Ah, well, you've won one game each. Shall I play the winner?
It's my understanding we're all playing together, Victor, that we're all winners.
Well, of course.
I trust, Victor, that the plant will be producing by the end of the summer. My contacts are waiting eagerly.
Well, I see no reason why we can't be.
Benny Smith, you're the engineer. What do you think?
Well, yes. Well, now, I should have to know quite a bit more about the subject before I could venture an opinion on that matter. Would you care to discuss it with me this morning?
No. There's plenty of time. Your reputation as an engineer is excellent. I'm quite sure that you'll be on top of the situation as soon as we arrive to our destination.
Well, let's all enjoy this trip. Good sea air, great company, and then we'll all rest it for the big job ahead.
Oh, good morning, everyone.
Hello.
Or should I say good afternoon?
Well, Alex, you didn't say good morning to me.
Oh, but I do. I was just waiting for my cue.
Oh.
Well, I certainly wouldn't want to spoil your entrance.
You never could, darling.
Well, of course I couldn't. Especially when you're dressed like that. Don't you think it's a little early for this sort of thing?
Oh, do you think so? Well, perhaps I should have borrowed something a little more appropriate from you. An ocean or a bathrobe, perhaps. Don't worry, darling. I wouldn't dream of bothering you for something like that.
Still your sweet self there.